door.
I'd like to call the Delaware County Commissioners meeting in order. It is Monday, June 19th, 2017. The time is now 9 o'clock. Everybody could please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Steve, could you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Here.
Ms. Reagan.
Present.
Mr. King.
Here.
Mr. Brough.
Present.
First, we have a public hearing. The public hearing to consider public works project using employees of accounting for project 156 at County Road 625 East with the placement of bridge structure, estimated cost less than $250,000. Do you have anybody here to speak on behalf or against?
Angie, this was a project at Bridge 156, correct?
Correct. It's located on County Road 625 East over a branch of White River, Liberty Township.
And I sent to the commissioners the breakdown on the cost. The structure itself is $100,000, a little over $100,000. Correct, Angie?
Yes.
And the rest of the cost is for the the labor and equipment that are needed to do that particular project. Angie, do you feel that the workforce in Delaware County, they've done this work before, correct?
Yes, they're familiar with this work, done it many times, they do a great job.
Okay.
Anything else? Entertain a motion to close the public hearing.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to close the public hearing. Steve, could you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Next, we have appointments. We have two appointments to the Yorktown Public Library, Donna Miller and Pat Freeman.
Also move.
I'll second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, could you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Next, we have an appointment to the Cree Board, Doug White.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, could you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Next, under table business, we have an application for the County Edit Grant Funds for a Better Life Grant as Hope. Can we get a motion to take that off the table?
I'll make a motion we take that off the table.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to remove it from the table. Steve, can you call the roll?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
We do have.
Yes, we do have a couple from Brianna
Super and Mr. Davis.
Yeah. Please step up.
We've received this application from the Better Life Grant as Hope. Requesting $12,000. Mr. Cooper, could you explain, Mr. Davis, could you explain how you would use this to help the citizens of Delaware County?
Sure. Just so you guys know, over the past 2 weeks, we've recently sent four people from Delaware County to rehab detox. The cost of that is initially $255, and then it would be $420 to send them on to a residential therapy, and then if they wanted to go to extended stay, it's $125 per week, and we pay for 2 weeks of that. That's a little over $800, nearly $900. So in the past couple weeks, we've been pushing the $4,000. That money would be used to get people back into rehab and treatment. I don't have the exact figure of the Delaware County people. Do you have that?
No.
That we've sent, but over the past 6 months, we've sent several people from Delaware County. This helps them get their life back on track. It helps them with their recovery. It helps them get their families back together. We've had people who've actually had their families and their children reinstated back to them. So we do this kind of stuff to help people out. HIP 2.0 takes care of a lot of things, but it doesn't doesn't take care of everything. The other thing is, a lot of people who are dealing with addiction do not get insurance. Their money's being used for, but yet they come to that point in their life when they realize that it's either I do this now or I die. And they start, we had a gentleman just recently that we, one of the four that we just sent, he was scared. He went to the doctor because he knew he was having some health issues. Found out that his liver was failing. And it's his wake-up call. It's hard to tell when somebody's wake-up call is going to be. But that was his wake-up call. So he is in, at this moment, he is in rehab detox right now. And we've been able to take care of that for him here in Delaware County. So that's what we do. Not only do we do that to help people get in as a reactive type thing, but as I've shared with you guys in the grant proposal, we're also proactive. We get out in the county. We get out in the community. We're right now working at my chapter over at Delville to get a card out to every person in the Salem Township area so that they know about us. One of the things that happens is people, they get in these closed communities and they don't know that there's help out there, or they don't know what kind of help is out there. So one of the things that we're going to do is send these postcards out. Some of you may have seen it on the Facebook, on our Facebook page. We're going to get these postcards out and send them out to the people in the community so that they know. Other chapters, we've just recently grown to 18 now, right? 18 chapters. So other chapters are going to be able to do this too. With the three chapters that are currently in Delaware County and looking for more, we'll be able to use this money in Delaware County to help those who are searching out and also make awareness for people who might be looking for help or the families who are looking for a way to go.
So this is for the body of the program, not just one chapter?
We'll be using it, the bulk of it, for Delaware County,
right,
which would be the Delville chapter, the Albany chapter, and also the Muncie chapter. And looking to, you know, just to put this really bluntly, the state's not prepared for this epidemic.
Oh, no.
And we don't have beds. We don't have facilities. Sometimes our folks that we're trying to get into a facility, they may have to wait 4, 5, 6, 7 days before they can get in. We just recently got information that the epidemic itself, the heroin epidemic itself, we're 2 years away from peaking. Just peaking, and it's a problem. And what our organization does is try to get out there and be very public about what we do and try to keep communities from sweeping it under the rug and not dealing with it. We're kind of in your face, but we think we need to be in your face because you can't hide this. It's affecting too many people, it's affecting too many families, and it's affecting too many children.
Just within the first quarter of this year, I was recently reminded, in Delaware County alone, there were over 200 emergency runs that were heroin and opioid related. There were over 25 deaths that were attributed. So obviously, you know, it's no secret what the problem is. The problem is finding the solution, and we just feel like we're a part of that.
Thank you.
I'd just like to say, not too long ago, I knew a young man that he died of a heroin overdose. And the day after his funeral, his dad got the phone call that there was a room up for him. Mm-hmm. For this. So, you know, it's one of those things. We need to do something. We need to help our community. The heroin epidemic, I mean, it is getting very bad out there. Our officers can't even field test the stuff anymore because it's laced with fentanyl and everything else. And, you know, there's where police officers even get it on their uniform and brush it off, and it sinks into their skin, and they're overdosing. You know, so, yeah, we need to do something about it. And we do need to help people. And it not only affects the addict, but you are right, it affects the family, friends of the addict. So I appreciate everything that you guys do for our community.
The ripple effect just goes on and on for schools, yeah, and everything else, CPS, yeah, and yeah, you're right.
And one of the things, I just might add this, one of the things that my brother-in-law is a retired Muncie police officer. seen the effect that it's had on him. Mm-hmm. I've seen the effect of friends who are EMTs and the effect of friends who are firefighters. Yeah. You know, you either can become very jaded, which is understandable,
yeah.
or you just, your heart gets broke for these families because you're walking in and their child's gone. Yeah. And whatever we can do to prevent that here in Delaware County, and then as far as ABOBH is concerned, throughout East Central, well, throughout Indiana,
yeah.
we're going to do it.
Well, a lot of people see the addict. They don't see the children that's being born
yes,
addicted. They don't see the effects that it has on families. Us as public safety, we see a lot of that. So it's just not helping the addict. It's helping everybody in a whole. It's helping the community. So.
Yes, sir. And the reason we came to you is, our organization has been very blessed. I do want to say that the Lord has blessed us mightily. But we still need help.
Right.
And the help that we need comes in financial form a lot of times. And that's why we came to you to ask you to help us help our communities.
Thank you both.
Thank you.
Great.
I appreciate you.
I'll make a motion that we approve $10,000 for the Better Life Grant. So,
second that.
Have a motion and a second. Anybody else have anything to say on this matter? Steve, could you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you,
sir. Next, we need the approval of June 5th, 2017 minutes.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
King.
Yes. Next, we have contracts and agreements for approval. Agreement to provide professional consulting services.
This is the agreement for Dossett Consulting Services. This is a request from the auditor.
If you remember back, commissioners, Maximus used to do our incidental collections. I asked to do a one-year contract with Dossett Consulting. For 2016, he was able to recover $136,000 for the county. His cost was $2,000 less than what Maximus previously charged the county. And so I'm asking that we go ahead and do a three-year contract this time instead of a one.
John, was you able to look over the contract?
I was. I found it nothing unusual about it. Seemed to be pretty standard.
I'll make a motion to approve the consulting contract.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry?
Yes.
Ms. Reagan?
Yes.
Mr. King?
Yes. Next, we have the LPA consulting contract for Bridge 141.
Morning, commissioners. This is a boilerplate contract developed by the Indiana Department of Transportation. This is for construction inspection services with American Structure Point. This has been reviewed by NDOT. They found acceptable. And the contract is not to exceed $285,475.63, which will receive 80% of it reimbursed through federal funds.
What's the timeline on that? Spring will be.
Hopefully, if we get the right of way secured, that's our goal.
Yeah. I'll move that we adopt.
I'll second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next, we have professional service agreement for Bridge 268.
This is for engineering services, right-of-way engineering and inspection services for the bridge located on 23rd Street over Buck Creek. This will be a superstructure replacement. The Creed Board has approved funding this project, so I just need authorization to contract to the commissioners. And I do have a representative from United Consulting if you have any questions.
Just getting quite mad, isn't it?
Yes.
The not-to-exceed amount is $125,200. That's for all phases, not including construction, but for all engineering services.
I know I asked
question at the Creek Board, but it will be restructured to where it can handle the truck traffic.
Correct.
When's that hooked in?
They have to go to construction next year.
Spring, awesome.
I'll make a motion when you approve the agreement.
Second.
Have a motion, a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next, we have a professional service agreement for Bridge 501.
This is a similar contract of $268. This is with United Consulting for a not-to-exceed amount of $153,000. Creed will be funding all phases of this project. I just need commissioner's approval on the contract.
So that one's just over there south of Red Dog?
Just north of.
Oh, north of, yeah, north of Red Dog.
I'll make a motion when we approve the agreement.
Second.
Have a motion, a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Are those roads gonna be, that road gonna, that road will be able to stay open?
We haven't gotten that far yet, but we'll try.
If you have two closed.
They will not be closed at the same time, but I would like to go out for bid for both projects and then, you know.
Stagger.
Yeah.
They're sensitive.
I think we'll get better prices that way. Thank you, Commissioner.
Yeah, thank you.
The agreement for collections of the personal property taxes, the treasurer, Ed Carroll, asked that we table this. He will not be here today for personal reasons.
I'll make a motion to table it.
Second.
Have a motion, a second, to table. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
There was a component about terminating some, one contract and entering into another contract. Are we tabling both matters? Because the termination takes 60 days.
No, I thought it had expired.
I don't have anything on the termination.
Let me see. Let me
Because I know there was talk on the termination.
Let me just double check this.
I'll see what I need. I think it's 30 days, John.
30 days?
I think it's 20. I think he's already given a 30-day notice.
Has he?
Yeah. I think he sent a letter, to the previous attorney.
I'm looking at the agreement right now.
This one's in section 7.
It's 60 days, actually.
Is it?
Yep.
I thought you told me they copied exactly the way it was.
Use the one I have says 60 days. 60 days written notice when I think he sent that out June 1st. Thank you very much.
Next, we'll move on to ordinances for second reading. Ordinance number 2017-001B, ordinance establishing a hazmat fund.
This is an ordinance we've already introduced. This is an ordinance to make a change to the very first ordinance of the year so that we can set up the State Board of Accounts with some wording change. This is for the EMS department.
So move.
Second.
Have a motion, a second. On the.
Thank you, Mr. President. Ron Quakenbush, President of Delaware County Council. I missed your January meeting when the increases in several special funds for the EMS were increased. And this hazmat was also in there as a new fund. And although I'm not opposed to establishing a hazmat fund, and I've talked to Jason, and we're going to watch this, and if it accumulates, we'll probably come back to you and ask you to reduce that, because that'll accumulate $48,000 a year, and it's just based on circumstances, so whether it has to be there, but it'd be good to have it in place. But the overall ordinance that was passed increased all of these funds by, if I remember right, I did some math on it, but I don't have it with me. I think it was $210,000. Now that $210,000 will come off of the operating balance of the county general fund immediately, because you're going to start collecting it right away. And I just wanted the commissioners to be aware that I will share this with the council members at budget time, because we're trying to go the other direction and increase the operating balance. And this will decrease it by a little over $200,000. This and the other increases.
I just want to speak to that. Ron knows what I'm getting ready to say, because we've had many discussions about this. As far as that increase goes, he is correct in that comes off of our billing fees that we do collect off the top, that before it goes into general fund. But the one thing that I will say in rebuttal to his statement is we've also gone above and beyond with our recouping the underpaid Medicaid, Medicare funds, and that is not unanticipated revenue that we've brought in. And I believe to date it's been over $300,000, and we anticipate another $150,000 this year, if not that doubling potentially for 16. So there is still a little bit of uncertainty on how much extra unanticipated money that we're going to bring in as well. So I just want you to be aware. Thank you.
Thank you.
We have a motion and a second. Steve, can you follow up, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Next, we have ordinance for first reading. We have ordinance number 2017-013, being a new floodplain management ordinance for Delaware County, Indiana. Morning, Mark.
Morning. Marty Moody with the Delaware Muncie Plan Commission. And this, a couple of years ago, FEMA established a new floodplain management template. And at the same time, they began a process where they were doing a new flood study for a part of York Prairie Creek. And so basically they told us that you could wait until we were done with that flood study in order to adopt a new ordinance. And the other thing I would say is that, well, the way we've done this is to delete the previous ordinance that was adopted in 2011 and adopt this new ordinance, but the substance of both remain essentially the same. There are small edits throughout the ordinance that if I had tried to do this so that each little thing was changed, we'd have pages of, you know, this, that, and the other. It's easier to just delete and replace. And it basically would be in effect, I think the way I wrote that was the effective date would be August 3rd, I believe, and the new flood maps through FEMA become effective around that same date. And if you have any questions, I'll be happy to try to answer them.
I'll make a motion to introduce ordinance 2017-013.
Second.
Have a motion and a second for introduction. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.
Thank you. Could we schedule the second reading for July 17th? Rather than July 3rd?
That sounds good to me.
That's just for me, because I might take that day off.
Well deserved.
You take on 17, Paul?
No.
As long as Jen can make a note of that.
Sure.
Next, we have ordinance number 2017-014, ordinance amending section 183 of Delaware County Code of Ordinance.
This is an ordinance that was brought to my attention by Mr. Spangler in the, in the HR department. There were some bad checks there, or dishonored checks that were coming through for some payments to his office, and there really wasn't a part of the county code which allowed him to collect fees for those bad checks. So he asked that we create an ordinance to amend this. This applies to all departments, unless there's a specific ordinance, all departments if they get a bad check.
So I don't see an amount, so fixed dollar amount. Did he have a suggestion what he wanted to charge?
I think the statute allows $20, but I'll double check that. If we want to introduce it, I can amend it, or you can put it on the table and
whatever you recommend, way of doing it.
You just want to go with the state amount, John?
Yeah, we'll go with the state IC code, but I'll put that in the ordinance. So I'll, if we introduce it, then I'll amend it for.
And we can just, when we do the second reading.
Right, yep.
Okay, thank you.
I'll make a motion to introduce 2017-014.
Thank you. Second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next, we have ordinance number 2017-015 for first reading, ordinance repealing and restating policy concerning health insurance benefits for current and retired employees of Delaware County.
This is a cleanup ordinance because of changes that the commissioners have made in with regard to retirees' health insurance and also health insurance for the employees. There are a number of ordinances that have been adopted over the years that we needed to clean up and or repeal in their entirety or amend in some regard so that it affects the current conditions. We didn't want conflicting ordinances out there between the current condition and the ordinances that were adopted many years ago. So this is a cleanup ordinance to take care of all that.
I'll make a motion to introduce ordinance 2017-015.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to introduce 2017-015. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next, we have resolutions for approval. Resolutions number 2017-028, a resolution to perform work by the Highway Department for Bridge 156 on County Road 625 East.
This is a resolution to approve the work that was part of the public hearing that Angie and I discussed at the beginning of this meeting to allow the county highway workers to perform the work.
I make a motion to approve resolution 2017-028.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next, we have resolution number 2017-029, a resolution to perform work by the Highway Department on North Walnut from County Road 500 North to State Road 28.
This is a resolution to allow approve the work done by the County Highway Department on Walnut Street from 500 North to 28, since it had a value between labor, materials, and equipment of over $100,000, and it needed to have the commissioner's approval. Mr. Jesse got these figures together for me, and so we needed to, the commissioners need to approve this, make sure that they approve the highway department performing this work.
Motion to approve resolution 2017-029.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Ms. Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes. Next up, department heads and elected officials.
Well, as a council member, I'm getting some of your calls on some of the highway work, and I received one last week. It turned out to be actually a failure of an emulsion that was purchased by the county, but I called the highway superintendent, and he picked me up and took me on about a 2 to 3 hour drive throughout the county. And I just want to compliment your workers on the work that they have done. And unfortunately, this failure looked real bad on them, but it wasn't their fault. They're doing their best to correct it by, it's a bleeding problem where the emulsion's bleeding through and actually not doing its job. It's not packing down, and it's coming up in layers, and he showed me that. And also, while you have me in the truck, he took an opportunity to show me a lot of your finished work that was very nice. And I just wanted to compliment the highway department on the work they are doing, and let the public know that they're on top of this problem, and it's in quite a few areas. Unfortunately, it like 20 some miles of road they did last fall, and the emulsion didn't stick. But the way they prepared the road is something that I've been trying to get somebody to do for years, and I don't mean to take this as personal, but grinding that road and then putting it back down in a nice straight surface full width and then chip sealing is a beautiful job when everything works the way it's supposed to, and I thank you for allowing them to do that way, because like he explained to me, it's about $15,000 a mile to do that prep work before they do the chip seal. But I think in the long run, that's going to really pay off. So thank you.
Thanks, Ron.
Thanks.
Do you have anybody else?
Angie, did you want to bring up about the bridge issue and the partial mortgage release?
Oh, yes, thank you for reminding me. We have one of the properties that we need to acquire right away. We came to an agreement on a settlement, but we need to sign off on a partial mortgage release. NDOT's policy is anything under $25,000, they approve, but you know, if something goes wrong, ultimately the county's liable. Something I was going to talk to MARTA, this partial mortgage release, depending on what mortgage company, can take months. So it's like we got to weigh the possibility of maybe losing our federal funds or hopefully getting it signed in time that the money, you know, everything's secure so we can go to letting. I don't know what your wishes are in regards to that. It's $18,000 and some change. I don't remember the exact figure. I don't know if you're comfortable with that. I'm not trying to talk you into anything. I just want you to know the possibilities. If we don't get all the right-of-way secured, it could affect our federal funding.
A partial mortgage release means that the part of ground that we are making the deal on is not going to be subject to a mortgage if the homeowner decides not to make their payments and it goes into foreclosure. If we don't get a partial mortgage release, then there's a possibility that if they don't make their payments and it goes into foreclosure, then that land that we've taken isn't covered by that, and we may have to pay again to the mortgage company for that. So Andrew's brought this up to me. The state has this policy, $25,000 or less. I'm surprised the state has a policy, but they've got a lot more money than Delaware County. Mm-hmm. I don't know how many times we want to pay for land, but it does hold up the project.
So
this is for the Tiger
that one. Oh, I thought it was for the partial. So what do we make a motion to?
You make a motion if you want to authorize it, allow for this particular bridge and this project to allow the county to obtain the property without a mortgage release. Correct, Angie?
And we can do it per parcel as it comes up if you feel better with that. Or if you're going to give me that permission for the entire project. Just a reminder, Yorktown was very kind and donated their right-of-way. That saved us a little bit of money. I'm not trying to talk you into anything, but the risk of losing your federal funds are there.
Right. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's...
I don't want to lose the federal money.
So we have to do it. So
I'll make a motion to approve it.
Second.
Have a motion and a second to approve the county to obtain the property without the mortgage release, correct?
Yes.
Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Ms. Regan?
Yes.
Mr. Henry?
Yes.
Mr. King?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't have anything else. We'll move on to payment of claims in amount of $1,100,645.93.
So moved.
Second. Motion and second. Steve, can you call the roll, please?
Mr. Henry?
Yes.
Ms. Reagan?
Yes.
Mr. King?
Yes.
Have any comments and questions from the public?
Frank Wild, 701 North Brentwood, Muncie. I just want to invite you to a meeting Monday, June the 26th. Jason Harp, who happens to be a member of the City Council of Fort Wayne, is going to explain to us what has happened to Fort Wayne since the regional city has given them $42 million. He has written a letter to the Fort Wayne Sentinel explaining how he sees this. Essentially, they've been given $42 million, which the taxpayers are going to have to match. They're turning the authority of the city officers are relinquishing their authority for 8 years to this organization concerning taxes. Let me find it here just a minute. This board will be appointed by the state. Who they will be, we do not know. The local officials cannot remove this board, nor can the public. They're armed with borrowing authority, taxing authority, the power of eminent domain. And Jason suggests that we really need to wait to see how this is going to come out. The meeting is at Kennedy Library, June the 26th, 6:30 p.m. And it's sponsored by the Muncie 912 Tea Party. If your permission, Mayor Margaret Nickel would like to pass out invitations to you as well as anybody in the audience. Margaret. And I really would like to see you come and see how Jason has evaluated what's happened in Fort Wayne. I'm trying to check on what happened in Evansville. It's kind of difficult to determine exactly, but Evansville has also signed an 8-year contract to have this board have taxing, eminent domain, and a lot of authority that the local officials are elected to use to benefit the citizens. I feel like giving this authority over to an appointed board that we cannot control is going to really affect our property values and our property rights as citizens of the city here.
Thank you.
And it, as you may know, you probably know, it's embraced the 10 county, but Muncie is one that's applied for the money.
So we didn't get...
Pardon?
We didn't get the one of the three, the state.
No, but they're applying at the present time, continuing to apply for the money. It would be a great cost to the taxpayers of the city, I would say. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you have anyone out there?
Good morning.
Morning.
We are from the west side of town.
You need
yes.
to put your name and address.
John Stevenson, West Lawn Park, Muncie. And in case you don't know, that's out in the Gill Brothers. We presented a petition here a while back on road repairs. Brought a couple gentlemen from the addition, plus our petition. We've been in the addition for 35 years, and it's never been repaired as far as repaved. We're asking for the proper steps as to what we need to do to continue on and to possibly get our addition repaired or replaced. We're looking at one addition, four roads, approximately a mile and a quarter of pavement is all we're looking at. So I brought two gentlemen here that would also like to speak to you. I thank you for your time. And if you could give us the next step, we would be more than willing to try to take that.
John, we've spoken, we've never met, but.
Yes, yes. And to answer your question, in that one area where we were talking about drainage, there is three drains.
I saw those. And I did turn that in last week, and Angie's replied to it. So we are looking at those current drains. We could, because the water could not get down to it, so.
Yes.
Maybe today or tomorrow, we might be able to get out there and relieve that problem.
Yes, and they put the stuff on, it washes down the drains, and it clogs the drains. So then we have a flood problem a couple times a year. So we're just looking for the proper steps to go through to get the job done.
And this is Angie Moyer, our project director, and she helped out at the Country Village. They had some terrible issues. So Angie is aware of it and is working with one of your consultants, I believe.
Yeah, between myself and my inspector, we went out to your neighborhood 3 or 4 times last week during the different rain events. Some minor repairs could really make a difference in getting the water off the road. Some berming, some trenches to your catch basins, because it's not a curb and gutter subdivision. I noticed some of the residents need to replace their driveway pipes. That's the responsibility of the property owners. On the back road, I noticed one, if that was replaced, it would really get water moving to the catch basin.
And I believe there's one driveway that doesn't have any water.
Some do, some don't. There's some swales in the area. Like I said, it's pretty minor stuff that we could do to get the large ponding off the road. I know I've discussed with Bob Jesse, the highway superintendent who oversees the paving, the possibility of looking at the entrance for now.
Yeah, just a 200 feet.
Just for this year. I think that might be some, I don't want to speak for Bob, but I think we might be able to work that out. In regards to the rest of the subdivision getting paved, I don't make those decisions.
I'm sure his schedule's getting filled. That would be very nice, Robert.
We have a lot of old subdivisions that have not received paving, and we just don't get enough money a year to stretch for 800 miles of road.
Right.
Maybe Bob could share what an average mile costs, so people can understand.
Bob Jesse, Delaware County Highway. We've addressed issues out there at Westlawn on several occasions. There is some holes that we patched, and there's probably more holes that need to be patched. As far as the paving, we talked about doing 100 feet of the entrance. The rest of the addition, is it completely gone? No. I've got roads that's nothing but dirt.
Right.
And I have to keep those repaired. So, you know, if we can get the entrance this year, maybe next year we can get in there and do some paving. Mm-hmm. It's just unfortunate that there's not enough money to go around to do all the roads that need to be done. You know, a mile road, by the time we go in there and prep it, get it ready, we're going to spend $65,000.
But you're dirt patch.
That doesn't sound like a lot of money, but it is when you've got 750 miles of road that you're trying to keep open.
But your dirt patch did do a nice job. I mean, they leveled them out.
That's what we would use on it.
Yeah.
And that's what they're seeing out there.
Right, but it is a drainage issue.
But getting to the material, the remark you made about the material washing into the drain, you're going to get a little bit of that. And it's not necessarily from what we're doing. It's from the deterioration of what you have in place right now. You know, the old blacktop, it just rolls and it just continues to run off. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it's just, it's...
And the new sweeper truck does a nice job getting all that gravel cleaned
too.
It does.
We have swept the neighborhood this year.
Yeah, I've known. You can tell.
I have two other gentlemen that would like to make comments also. Thank you.
Thank you, John.
My name is Raymond Wolf, and I've lived at 7800 Westbrook Drive for 49 years. I have seen... It was blacktop when I moved in. 32 years ago, they put in the sewer. That's the last time we've had blacktop put on the road. rest of the time it's been patched for 32 years. The last time they resurfaced Road 500 West, they left a 6-inch drop, 500 into entrance or addition. And we've never been able to get that repaired. As far as the chips and the tar you put on there, it's not doing the job. And I don't care what you say, it's not doing the job. We got 33 houses in that addition. Even during the blizzard, they never came out and plowed it. We had Mr. Ritchie come down with it and clean off one of the driveways, and the neighbor went around the addition with his snow blade so we could get in and out there during the blizzard. But for 32 years, I haven't seen nothing except patch. And it's as bad as, I can't say any more about it.
Right.
Thank you very much.
My name is Richard Ramsey. I live at 7801 West Fern Drive, right across the street from Mr. Wolf. I guess what I'm looking for is a timetable. Can you at least tell us, like, maybe next year you can be put onto this list? Because every year that we've talked to somebody, it's always, well, we've ran out of money, we've ran out of money. You weren't on the list this year. So at least put us on the list so we have something to look forward to. Something we can say, yeah, it's going to be done next year. I understand that money is tight and they're getting less and less money every day. But when I've paid taxes in the same place for over 30 years, I would hope that I could get a little bit more of what I'm getting. Thank you.
We can put roads on a 100 list, but what we say, okay, this year here's what we intend on doing. You have to look at there again, that 750 miles of road. If your road is a 5 on a 1 to 10, and I have a road that is completely gone, so making it a 2, you know, you have 30 houses on your road. These roads that are in the county, there's hundreds of people drive on them every single day. And we have to look at what is most important to all the taxpayers, not just to your addition in general. We have several additions that's in the same shape that yours is in. And our intentions are at some point to get them paid. But this year, I can't say that we can do it this year. We'll get your entrance done this year. But all the roads in your addition, probably not. You know, just be honest.
Anybody else? I'd like to bring up that July 1st all the budgets are due, and commissioners really haven't addressed it this year. I'm starting my 5th year as a county commissioner, and I still believe that we need a civil engineer on staff. And it's just things like this that come up, that it'd be nice to say to the servant, could you meet me out at 500 West, 500 North, whatever the problem is? Because we have these consultants, we pay some $20,000. Plus the state gives us $20,000. So I'm only asking that we turn in July 1st, $60,000 out of highway and $40,000 out of bridge, and just at least put it on the schedule that we can talk about hiring a civil engineer that has 5 years experience, that can take care of our 750 miles of road, our 194 bridges, our 14 buildings, and then the 1,400 miles of ditches. We need someone to get the policy written down, to keep us accountable, and I guess that's my elevator speech for today.
Anything else?
So that means it falls on deaf ears.
I thought you'd just given a speech.
Well, I'd just like to have Angie turn in $40,000 on her bridge budget and have Robert turn in $60,000 on his highway budget.
I'm not interested in that myself, but.
A county this size should have someone at the top that can help new policy. We have two buildings that we just spent $3 million in, and we need someone that can keep things running.
That's Charlie's job.
I don't think Charlie has, I think he's got his hands full.
Charlie takes good care of our buildings. Appreciate you, Charlie.
I do appreciate Charlie. I just think he could use some help.
Anything else? Entertain a motion to adjourn. Well, a motion to recess.
So moved.
I'll second that. Keith, can you call the roll?
Mr. Henry.
Yes.
Reagan.
Yes.
Mr. King.
Yes.